report is a little different. I miss the book reports.
It's different, but I think I like it. I can make a report on something that really interests me.
Yeah, but I'm interested in sports. Can I write about that?
Well, I think so. Let's see, the reports are on occupations. You could write about, well, say, the life of a professional football player.
Say, that's an idea. But what are you going to write about?
Well, I haven't really decided yet. I'll have to think it over. Well, I'll see you around.
Dan would have to think it over. Thinking it over was the first step in preparing his class report. His assignment, to make a report on an occupation. What occupation? It should be something that would interest him and his class. At dinner, Dan was thinking it over. Dinner is a real family gathering at his house. Maybe Dan could get some help in picking a topic. Maybe he should ask Dad. He usually has a suggestion. Or maybe he should ask his brother. Pete must have had class reports to do. But no, thought Dan. This is the time to think for myself. Develop one of my own ideas. The next day, Dan began to narrow down the possible subjects. He thought of things he liked to do and subjects in which he had special interest. Railroads had always interested him. He even made model trains. There were all sorts of occupations in that field. He liked sports of all kinds, but then his friend Ted was probably going to report on that. He liked automobiles and mechanical things. He did. But what about his audience? How many of them would be interested in the life of a mechanic? Dan wanted a subject that he could make interesting to everyone in the class, just as he hoped their reports would interest him. Dan also wanted a topic that would make the work of preparing the report more interesting for him. Look, a farm. Dan knew he had found his topic. The library would be his base of operation, and the card catalog his first source of information. Under the subject listing, he found available books that might help him with his report. Dan was careful to pick books that were really informative, rather than any literature that presented a slanted viewpoint. He kept a list of the books he used. This is called a bibliography. Besides including this list in his report, Dan would give credit in a footnote whenever he directly quoted an author. Magazine articles occupied Dan's attention on another trip to the library. He found these by consulting the Reader's Guide, which indexes articles appearing in magazines and other regular publications. These two he included in his bibliography. Then Dan discovered another source of information, films that gave him a real insight into the life of a farmer. At home, by checking the newspapers, Dan found there were many radio programs that could help him with his research.
Makers of the world's finest chicken feed present the Farmer's Almanac of the Air. First, the weather report, then a quick rundown of grain prices. After, this message of interest to every farmer who wants to increase...
But still, Dan felt his research was not complete.
Say, Dad, I'm making a class report on the life of a farmer. How can I go to a farm and find out what it's really like?
I don't know, son. There are no farms close by. Maybe you could work on a farm this summer.
You don't understand, Dad. My report's got to be in next week. I just have the weekend off. A couple of days.
Well, let's see. Your Uncle Jack has a farm, but he's pretty busy with his family and all the work and everything.
Well, I could help him out, couldn't I?
I'm afraid you wouldn't be much help to him.
Well, I'll try, Dad. Honest, I will.
Well, all right. You call him up, and if he says all right, I'll let you go.
Swell, Dad. Excuse me. Information, please.
So Dan found himself up on the farm for the weekend. This was certainly different from life in the city. People were spread out more. Just when Dan thought the day's work was all done, there were a lot more chores. He tried everything, though not always with great success. When he could, he took pictures that would be part of his report. It was a long day, but after dinner, Dan made some notes on the day's activities, little incidents he might use in his report. But tomorrow is another day, and Uncle Jack's family went to bed early. For once, Dan wanted to go to bed. In one day, he had learned quite a bit about the life of a farmer. The next day was Sunday, and although the farmers still had morning chores and some distance to travel, the country church was well attended. Soon after church, it was time for Dan to go home. He had had an interesting visit to his uncle's farm. He had made a personal investigation that was fun for him and would add life to his report. To guide him in preparing his class report, Dan had a checklist. It was time to look it over. Choose a subject. Well, remember? Dan had done that. He had almost asked for help. But in the end, his idea was his own. Think of your interest and your audience. Dan's topic was one that interested him, and he felt he could make it interesting to everyone in his class. Next, gather information. He had certainly done that. He'd made frequent trips to the library for research of all kinds, from books, magazines, and films. And he'd made a personal investigation of his topic to give him a further knowledge of the subject. Organize presentation. Now, Dan had a week to do that. As he started to think about organizing his material, he began to feel he would need the week. At first, what he had learned came to him in jumbled, unorganized thoughts. It was going to take work. Dan was glad he had had experience in outlining and revising outlines, organizing material in a clear, effective manner. Because Dan was interested in his work, and because he knew he had done it well, he had a real sense of accomplishment. And he actually was looking forward to the day he would make his report. There are many ways to make a class report. Could you organize and present a report now that you've seen Dan go through the process? How would you present your class report?